3, 2, 1.
Hey everyone, welcome back to Equip Tip episode 9. Today we're talking about work-life balance. Is it possible to do it well? Now for those that are watching this, I'm sure you're in the areas of business, in sales or the likes. You're doing something, you've got a vision, you're working hard, maybe you're doing a couple of jobs, maybe you're building something in the background, whatever it may be. You'll know that this one's pretty tough, particularly for those that are, you know, married, significant relationship, kids, you know, all that sort of stuff adds to this. It seems that time gets reduced as you add more things to the equation. So really, I want to give you 3 tips that I use. It's still a challenge for me running a few different businesses, consulting all over Australia, New Zealand, producing content, managing teams, a whole lot. So with a wife and 2 kids, but I love it. I love it all the same. So here's my 3 tips, and I hope it helps you, hope it gives you some value. But step number one is, a lot of people use this word balance, and I think balance is not actually the right word to use here, because you will never find balance. It's like a seesaw. You know, if you go to the park and you see a seesaw, it's very rare that it's actually perfectly weighted and it's just sitting in the middle. You know what I mean? Like, you just touch it here and it slowly pulls down this way, and this side goes up and then it bounces back the other way. That's what I kind of think about when we're talking about work and life. It's never balanced. You're either spending a little bit more time this week with work because you've got deadlines you need to get it done, or sometimes you're a little bit more on the life side of things because you're not feeling overly motivated, and it kind of swings back and forth. See, looking for balance is not attainable, in my opinion. So a better word is blend. I want to throw out the seesaw altogether and come up with a blender. How do I put work and life into one thing so that they all sort of start to get intertwined and come together? Because then we're not chasing balance, we're looking for blend. How do I introduce my personal life into my business life? And how do I introduce my business life into my personal life so then it's all just life? Then there's no distractions, okay? So step number one is focus less on balance, focus more on blend. Number two is you need to over-communicate. This is a big one. Anytime, any form of relationship breakdown, because typically what happens here, the result or the evidence of poor work-life balance is relationship breakdown. Either the relationship isn't strong with your employees, your team, whatever it may be, your work life, or your relationship isn't strong at home with your kids, with your wife, with your husband. So the way that you overcome that is you need to over communicate, meaning take the 10 seconds to just download and say, cool, this is what I'm working on at the moment. Or this is what this month looks like for me. Or this is what the next few days look like for me. What's your days looking like at the moment? And spending that time to actually make sure everyone's on the same page. And how do you do that? Well, I call it micro time blocking. It's the 30-second text message. It's the 1.5 minute phone call. It's the 3 minutes on the couch at the end of the day where there's no distractions. You don't have your phone, the TV's off, you're just talking. It's the 4 minute staff meeting. It's the 13 second Slack message. This is all the stuff I do, right? It's those little micro time blocks. It's the, I'm driving from one appointment to the next, and instead of just chilling for 4 minutes, I use that 4 minutes to call my wife and just see how her day's going. That's what I mean by the blend. It's over communicating and micro time blocking. It's using those little pockets throughout the day to ensure that this is a nice, healthy smoothie and nothing's over the top. You don't have too much banana and not enough cinnamon. That is my answer to how you achieve great work-life balance or blend. It's being disciplined to do this well, because really at the end of the day, life is so much around just meaningful conversations with other human beings. So take time to do that and you'll find everything else gets put into perspective, and in fact, you get better outcomes because of it. So there it is. Hope you enjoy it. A little bit more philosophical this week, but if you've enjoyed this video and you want to get access to 600 more just like this, but even in more detail around sales, marketing, business development, proposals, follow-up, language patterns, human behavior, like my life's work is in this project called equipconsulting.online. I want to give you 30 days, I should say, free membership, so you can check it out, you can start to learn, you can apply it to your life and your business. I'd love for you to head over there, use the coupon EquipTip, get free access for 30 days. Go over there, check it out, and see you on another video very soon.